time is now. With the wreath in hand, we can begin the redemption of my city and my people. I must make the gods see that my people can be redeemed for the faults of Arches. With the wreath in hand, I can conduct a ritual of atonement. As you bear the cipher, the conduit to the gods, you will bear witness. Come. We must conduct this ceremony at the site of our original transgression. Let us go to the Hyperion. We must act. You have come, good. We stand in a ground once hallowed beyond all things, now tainted by the excommunication of my people. Ever since that terrible day when arrogance and desperation brought about the disfavor of the gods, my followers have tended this place. Now come. We shall go to the antechamber of the Hyperion, the very spot where the sins of the Colossi were answered. We are so close now. Much was ruined in that dark hour. The magics holding the paths together were unbound. Only the cipher can reorder such magics. Press ahead. Set the path. We are almost done, Beckett. We have reached it. Beyond that stone is the Hyperion, the gift of the gods, the symbol of a covenant concluded. It rests out of reach, waiting for the day when the gods forgive our trespass, and they find us worthy again. Until now, I feared such a day would not come. We should begin. The gods visited this room once before. It seems only fit that you occupy their position. I will take my place where Arceus once stood. The end of this awaits. Them after all this time. I bear witness to their confirmation. You have done so well, Beckoned, to bring the cipher to me and to let me use its strength. With you, I can do what Arceus could not, command the Hyperion. This chamber harnesses the magic needed to control the Hyperion. Before you appeared with the cipher, no force was sufficient. I knew that when we first met, when I first sensed the cipher, that I could unseal the Hyperion and command its power. Why else would the gods furnish you, whom I needed most in my lowest hour? The gods have found my people unworthy of the gifts offered us. So, using the Hyperion, I will see Idylla destroyed. The wicked will be purged. And once the city falls, I will reforge the ruins in an image the gods find acceptable. I'm sorry, Beckon, but you must be a martyr for my cause.
You are dead.
Thank you. beckoned. What has happened? Why are Onokatos' acolytes attacking us? What is he doing with the Hyperion? Destroy Idylla? No. That zealous fool. Have the loss of his gods driven him to such despair to use the beckoned and the cipher for such ends? We must make our way from this place. We cannot stop Onokatos from here. Take this shield. One of my soldiers dropped it when the Silent Choir ambushed us. I hope it protects you better. Be cautious in these lands. Onokatos has sealed himself in with the Hyperion, and his Silent Choir will lay down their lives for him. I do not know what to do, Beckoned. I have defended my people from beasts and disasters, but nothing like this. Of course, I will not let Onokatos destroy my people because he believes the gods demand it. I know we have the strength we need inside of us, despite his claims. We are worth saving, even if the gods disagree. But Onokatos has sealed himself in the Hyperion antechamber. Without the cipher and knowledge of the Hyperion, we are lost. Onokatos was clever by exploiting your power. The cipher must be the key to unlocking the Hyperion, and he has broken it in his plan. But that is the one thing my people have been unable to do since we first came here. Only the Primos would know enough about the riddle for us to even try. Onokatos and his Silent Choir had a monastic retreat in the wilderness, Nyxaros. If we need his knowledge, we best start our search there.